But there are a lot of people supporting this guy. Actually, to the tune of 120,000 people have signed up to help with his campaign. But the only problem with this is that there are actually no tools to put these people to use. You know, 120,000 people said, I want to do all I can do to get this guy elected. And, you know, they signed up on the email list, so they'll probably hack the internet. But there isn't really a way to organize these people to actually put them to task of doing this. And not only that, the people running this campaign are actually very concerned about having 120,000 people working for the campaign that don't actually work for the campaign. They don't actually have control over it. You can imagine the issues if someone like KKK for Dean popped up. What are they going to say? But I want...
How many votes would they get?
Right. Well, true. But I want to prove to them that you don't need control of your campaign if you have enough communication. So I started this working group to start building tools that would allow an autonomous campaign organization to emerge. I guess that's the buzzword to use. That would put these hundreds of thousands of people potentially to use and organizing his campaign across the country. And the way we decided to do this was to break them up into geographic or interest-based groups that we call nodes. So you have cities that are running a city campaign group, or you have people who are interested in like a sport or like outdoorsmen for Dean, their campaign group, and you give them open source tools that are pretty modifiable that they can set up on their own web servers. And they're basically communities in a box, so they set them up and they plug them in, and then all the people who are associated with this geographic or interest group can go and sign into the web space, and they can talk with all the people who are in the area or have the same interest. And there'll be forums, and there'll be calendars, and all the great community tools that we've come to know, right? But the cool thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna link them all together, and we're gonna do it in a way that allows the network to grow and expand to its full potential. So we aren't actually gonna control any of the actual network. We're just putting the tools out there. And the nodes will be connected with something called RSS, which is, this is a bad analogy, but it's kind of like a pipe. And you can put content through the pipe, and you can allow the different nodes to share all the different content, like news, or maybe pictures, or videos, or whatever they have, like, or the calendar events. So basically, we're setting up these micro communities, and then we're going to try to weave them together. And there's going to be a hierarchy of communication, but again, not control. So you have states that have like a state, like Pennsylvania, Virginia, and then all the cities sign up underneath it. I might be going a little bit long, you guys interested at all? Okay. So anyways, the way it works is that if there's nodes above you that have content that they think is relevant to all the nodes below you, then that information will be automatically copied to your node. So if Dean at the top signs onto his web space and puts in a news article entry and wants everyone to see it, then that'll be replicated on all the states nodes, and all state nodes would have it replicated on all city nodes. And that works for states too. So if states put up information, then all the city nodes get it. And this will work for, you know, if the interest groups want to create a hierarchy for themselves as well, they can do this. But we're not going to control any of this, and Dean's not going to control any of this. The people who make these communities will control this. So the other thing we want to do is have something called bubble-up syndication. So if a user submits something that they think is relevant to their node, and the administrator of the node thinks it's relevant, they can push a button and it'll be put on the website, and then everyone in the node can see it. And then if other city nodes or other nodes in the same hierarchy or anywhere else think it's relevant, they can also syndicate the material. And then you have thresholds. So if stuff is rated high, so a lot of people are syndicating this, then other nodes might automatically replicate it to themselves as well. So the idea is that one user at the bottom of the system can submit something, and it can go all the way up to the top, and then be replicated in all the different nodes, and all the 100,000 other people can see this. So it's a really fancy IT infrastructure that will be designed to be autonomous and to operate very effectively in getting our friend Dean into the White House. So, and that's a system, that's a technology, and it has democracy imbued in it, but it is not democracy. The people who are running that will be democracy.